Welcome to Hot Garbage Sports. I'm Coach Ryan D. Oh my f***ing God. Did you see UFC tonight? Wow. That is the best pay-per-view I have watched from the UFC in like the last 5-6 years. Not even talking about the fights, just pure entertainment factor. Adrenaline from the minute they said go and that lit crowd in Jacksonville, Florida. Oof. And probably lit with COVID too, but whatever. They made the night. Stick with us through the intro till the end of the video because if you missed it, I can't even explain what we just saw. All right, hit the intro. Chris Weidman.
Who's that? Oh my God! That was the grossest thing I have ever seen since Anderson Silva. And the most insane thing about that is Anderson Silva broke his leg the exact same way on you. What was that?
Oh, if you didn't see the fight, Chris Weidman makes a leg kick to start the fight and breaks his shin in half. In half. There was no bone left. Right through. Breaks his shin in half. It was the grossest, most non-awesome thing I have ever seen, but I am jacked up about it right now. Go online, take a look at some of those pictures because like, okay, there's not much to note other than we really hope you end up okay. He is set for surgery tomorrow. Let's hope the man can come back. Let's hope the man can be better because that was just crazy.
And what else is crazy is to begin the night, the new Australian phenom Kroot comes in and has his knee destroyed so badly that his ankle ends up numbing due to a back leg kick that likely, from what I can tell, cut the nerve off, or at least the feeling in his leg, and his leg just folds over. It was the grossest thing I have seen in a long time. And then Chris Weidman happened. But let's break it down. Kroot, he's going to be good. That man finished the first round on one leg. One leg. I can barely make it up the stairs with two legs. And this man did it with one leg. He is tough as freaking nails. Oh my God. After those two fights, we get the killer, Shevchenko, Valentina. Oh, I love you. She is amazing. Oh my goodness. Little dance and everything after it. She punished tonight. That woman is a terminator. It is really too bad. She is 5 or 6 pounds too light to go back up and fight Nunes again. I know they fought twice. I know Nunes has beaten her twice, but I really just think it's a weight advantage for Nunes at this point. Shevchenko is one of the best pound per pound fighters the UFC has ever seen. Girl or not, you gotta love what Valentina was doing. That woman comes from a country ending in Stan. If you come from a country ending in Stan, you are automatically tough. And she comes from a country ravaged with mountains, ran by one of the world's worst dictators. She has guns on the side of her hip. And if you've ever seen her doing her best John Wick impersonation, I'm pretty sure she's a secret freaking agent. Shevchenko, oh, you're the best. Mid-fight, Daniel Cormier and Jake Paul end up getting into a, I don't know, spat? Jake Paul knows what he's doing. This guy knows how to capture attention. UFC fans all night ragging on Jake Paul, letting Jake Paul know what they think. But guess what? That Jake Paul brand keeps growing, and I think it's helping the UFC. Daniel Cormier gets called fat by Jake Paul. Cormier steps up. Now, probably not the best idea to call the former world heavyweight champion fat and maybe one of the greatest pound-for-pound fighters ever to exist in the UFC because, frankly, Cormier would friggin' you. But we all know Daniel Cormier is done fighting. We all know Daniel Cormier is a big fan of self-promotion. I love Daniel Cormier, but that man's media brand is on point. Daniel Cormier is a big WWE fan, and Logan Paul was recently at WrestleMania within the WWE. The Paul brothers and Daniel Cormier meeting up in a WWE ring may make sense one day. For Vince McMahon, for the Paul brothers, and for Cormier. Because let's be honest, if any of those Paul brothers actually got into a ring boxing or MMA with Cormier, he'd friggin' eat them. The next fight on the card, Thug Rose ends up taking the strawweight female championship from the Chinese superstar Zhang. Oh my goodness, Rose killed her. What a knockout kick. Did not see that coming. Unbelievable that Zhang couldn't block that. Hits her right on the button. She is out on her feet and wakes up when her head hits the mat. You can see it. I understand why she was so upset. She was pissed. The Chinese phenom was super, super pissed about the fact that they stopped that fight because she said she wasn't out. Watch the replay, honey. You were out.
You got knocked the fuck out, man.
but you did wake up when that mat hit you. Rose gets on top, beats her with a few hammer fists, new champ. And boy, was that Jacksonville crowd hot. Are we entering like a new Rocky Balboa style Cold War right now? Because people were all over the Chinese in that one. Oh my goodness, they let her hear it. So that American-Chinese rivalry, it is in full effect right now, baby. And USA ends up taking that one home through Thug Rose. Congratulations. The other thing I really want to point out that I thought was weird was Monster. Can we talk about advertisements for a second? Like, back off, Monster. You have the middle of the ring mat with a giant M. Everybody's trunks are wearing Monster. And then you make people classlessly hold an empty can of Monster after every win. Ugh, I thought that looked so freaking tacky. More tacky than advertisements on basketball jerseys or hockey helmets. We are really getting to a level where I personally am starting to get bothered by this. Shevchenko holding that can of Monster and holding it up like, yay, I'm the best. Ugh, my goodness. I just hate it. I know they're getting paid for it. I know money comes from it. Frankly, I shamelessly sell out too. Don't get me wrong. I would absolutely sit here and hold a can of Monster. What up, Monster? But it's starting to really look gross in billion-dollar promotions. Okay, main event time. Usman Masvidal. People love this Masvidal guy. Oh my God, what a popular fighter. And I understand the charisma is there, the fight finishes are there, the style is there, the attitude is there. This guy came out ready to go. After taking a fight with 6 days notice last time, Masvidal gets a full training camp, comes in, has an amazing first round, survives the takedown from the former D3 wrestler in Kamaru Usman. Looks like by 306 in the first round that he is starting to control the fight. He is controlling the center of the octagon with incredible strikes, pinpoint accuracy, and then he becomes kind of a cocky little bitch, and Kamaru Usman comes right down Main Street and bam, nighty night. And Kamaru Usman continues to assert the fact that he is the best pound for pound fighter in the UFC right now. Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, if you want to check out more UFC content, if you're a big combat sports fan like me, I check out every single one month to month. I'll be giving a couple breakdowns, my personal thoughts. I'm no fight expert, but I know what I like, and this was friggin' entertaining. So drop a like for me, smash subscribe if you want more MMA or you found your way here for MMA. Keep your hands up in the octagon. I'll see you next month.